To a follower of Christ, what prevails is not the situation but the principle. Nung iniisip ko to, when I was trying to reflect on this, iniisip ko, tama. Kasi may tinatawag na situational ethics. In other words, your conduct, behavior, response, and reflex depends upon the situation. Pero a Christian, hindi kasi siya thermometer, thermostat siya. Ang thermometer, kung ano yung temperatura ng surrounding, ganun siya. In other words, if you're a thermometer Christian, kung sino yung kasama mo, ganun ka na rin. Nai-influensyahan ka. You get their language, you learn their language, you learn to wear their dress, you learn to have their lifestyle, you become a thermometer Christian. Pero ang gusto ng Panginoon sa atin, hindi thermometer Christian, kundi thermostat Christian. Yung thermostat, kung ano yung sinet mo na temperatura ng thermostat, yun ang magsiset kung anong magiging temperature ng room. That is what a Christian should be. That wherever you are, whether sa career, sa eskwelahan, sa mga kaibigan, kahit pa kabats, colleagues, kahit sino pa, meron kang strong conviction na kaset na sa'yo ang mga non-negotiables na ito, kaya kahit saan ka magpunta, they do not influence you, but you influence them. Yan ang stand and make a difference. Kaya ngayong bata ka pa lang, you must establish those standards and principles in your life. Napakahalaga ito. Kasi when you begin to do that, that is equivalent to saying, Lord, I will honor you in my life. At alam mong sinabi ng Bible, hindi ka magkakamali pag in-honor mo ang Diyos. You'll never go wrong. Because when you honor God, the Bible says, God will honor you. You see? So, be a thermostat Christian. So, ang tanong dito, as a Christian, are you ready to stand and make a difference wherever you are? Because I'm telling you, when Daniel and his three friends, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, were taken into Babylon, they were thermostat Christians. Anong nangyari doon? Daniel and his friends were only four, but they were forceful in their faith. They were firm in their faith. They were faithful in their faith. But first of all, they knew where they stand. So do you know where you stand? Alam mo ba kung anong dapat mong paninindigan bilang isang kabataan? We want you to shine for the Lord Jesus Christ. Number one, don't be conformed to the world. Do you know the first step to resisting and to standing and making a difference for Christ is to renew the mind? You better change the operating system in the mind. You change the principles that operate your life. Kung dati ang sistema na nagpapatakbo ng buhay mo ay self or society, dapat ngayon is scripture. This age has now the most accessible sensualities, the most accessible na tayo sa mga sensual things than ever. Bawat tao may cellphone na. What does that mean? Access. And it would have been good if the access is restricted, filtered, and limited. Pero hindi. It's everything. And your access to these things, whether you like it or not, when you spend more time, it has a powerful influence to shape your behavior. Kaya bilang isang kabataan, maingat ka sa exposure mo. One of the things that have been taught to us that is very important for you to keep is their clothes, yung pananamit. In like manner also that women adorn themselves in modest apparel. Pag sinabing modest apparel, it covers. Hindi yung nakashort ka nga magmag na ditarwar. Ba't mo pinapakita yung legs mo? Don't you know if you're a lady, those sensitive parts of your body belong to your future husband? O sa mga lalaki naman, ang earrings para sa babae. Amen? And long hair belongs to women. Because the Bible says it is a shame for a man to have long hair. So these are some of the delicate yet serious issues, sensitive yet serious issues, that every young people, Baptist young people, should be able to address in their mind. And then be not conformed to their conversation and communication. Kaya sana naman bilang mga Christians and Baptists, we will not deny Christ with our speech. So if you are walking with Christ, you begin to adopt a life that is decent and godly. You begin to realize that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit of God. Be not conformed to their conduct, the behavior. So God has called us to a life that makes a difference. Thermostat Christian ka. It's about time that you become different in order to make a difference. Are you different from the world? Are you ready to take that stand? Are you equipped with biblical principles? So bilang isang Christian youth, what do you do? Prepare and brace yourself with biblical conviction. Kaya alam mo, tama yung sabi ni Conrad, the blessing of obedience ay hindi lang yung financially you will be blessed, pero wisdom. May favor ang Panginoon sa'yo when you obey God. Kaya young people, you better make up your mind. Kailan ka magsiseryoso sa pagiging Kristiyano mo? Kailan ka magsiseryoso na sundin ang sinasabi ng Biblia? Na panindigan ang biblical conviction and to make a difference. Don't be a thermometer Christian. Be a thermostat Christian. Stand and make a difference.